Shout out to my Golden Cherry Liquid IV. It is my second favorite of all their flavors. If you did not know, there's a new member of the top three Liquid IV flavors. It's not sponsored. I am an affiliate, so I'll leave my code down here if you want to use it. Start my morning with one of these every day. Passion Fruit still reigns supreme on my number one spot. Golden Cherry is our runner up at number two. And their newest release, which is Green Apple Tart, it's giving a green Skittle, sour Skittle. I love it. I love it. And they were even surprised when I said, oh, she made top three. They're like, top three? I was like, top three. Official as of May 2022. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we are testing the brand new Huda Beauty Faux Filter Luminous Matte Concealer. That's kind of confusing. I get where they're going with it though. Luminous Matte, currently available online for $29, and it will be available in store on June 13th. Looks like this. Hello, hello, and Miss Huda. It claims that it's suitable for all skin types and has 29 different shades. I will give you guys a shade range of models and swatches right now. So they sent me three shades and also two shades of their Easy Bake Powder. I don't know if these are my shades because I've tried, I think, like more of the yellowy. I don't know if it's called Banana. It might be something around there. I don't know. But I have Sugar Cookie and Cupcake today. One looks more like a transparent and the other one has a little bit of a light pinky tinge to it. It also had a Face Conceal and Blend brush, which is a round top, standard bristles within their line. It's kind of like that synthetic blend. It's very, very soft and it looks like it would be great for, you know, to spot concealing, but we shall see. I also started my day with some of their Wishful products. I actually took it off already, but I had the chin lift on. I've tried those things. I've given you guys my opinions before. I don't know if it really helped, but I felt a little puffy today and I'm gonna be outside for Memorial Day weekend barbecue festivities. I'm actually the host house for the neighborhood block party. It's like one of the bigger parties of the year and tents are already set up in my front yard, so I can't be late because then it gets real awkward. So let's get my face on, shall we? There's also this brand new Wishful Eye Lift and Contour. It's a serum and it has matcha, peptides, Arabian jasmine. Okay, I thought we could test it on one of my eyes. Why not? It also has a refillable cartridge. So it says, guess what? I'm refillable and recyclable. A little metal tip applicator. And while we pick an eye for this, ooh, you can already see it happening. Okay, let's give it to this eye. Feels great. I have my skin prepped already. I am using Elemis still. This is actually fully empty, but they recently sent me a mini size, but this is bare bones, buddy. But I've been using it for a few months now. I showed you guys when I first started. So that's on my skin, and this will be on my under eyes. I'm actually gonna bring it up here, the hollows. So as you can see, the old microblading lines are not concealed right now, and I do have my lashes on, but I just have brow pencil and lashes. My brows aren't done. I look a little cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs, but I figured we could test the concealer there. That's what we're here for, right? So while we let that kind of settle in, it feels really good. I'm gonna tell you guys about the highlighted ingredients while I open these concealers. So it's vitamin E and sweet almond oil. I don't know if the shades they picked for me are gonna work out. So here are the three different shades. I like the packaging, except I don't like this. I don't like how squished the font is here. I was like, I don't think you even really need that. But anyway, that's just me being an aesthetic picky gal. Here we are, there's a gigantic doe foot. The three shades we have today are Nougat at 2.5G, Coconut Flakes 2.7N, and Graham Crackers 4.1G. So we have two golden and one neutral. Referencing my own foundation shades, I do pull this up sometimes. My Huda Beauty shade is roughly 240N in the winter or 310G. So we might have potential here. We might have potential. I don't think I'm full summer yet, but I'm definitely not in the winter. So we're in that transition period. Definitely leaning closer to summer, but obviously not there yet. Nougat looks really light. Graham Cracker is not bad. I think Graham Cracker would be our closest skin tone situation out of the three. I'm actually gonna let these dry to see how that goes. While we apply our base, I'm gonna go with Rare Beauty's Tinted Moisturizer with SPF 20. This is in 30N. She's my gal lately. Ooh, ooh, we almost did that without a primer. Today we're gonna wear a primer because it's gonna be a long day. Maybe just in some areas, but let's try out the brand new Milk Makeup Primer together as well. This is the Pore Eclipse Primer. It's mattifying, and I think I wanna put that a little bit on the forehead just in case I break a sweat. Let's do a little of that today. Because if you can see, you may not be able to, but there's a little dryness under my nose right here. I did get a facial last week, so it might just be a little bit of purging. This is kind of like a silicone formulation, and I'm not gonna pull it too far around the face. It's taking said shine away immediately and giving a really flat finish. Why is my hair not understanding the assignment? Hello. I have not tried this yet, and I just wanna see if it will help our brow oiliness chill out. Plus, if I break a sweat while out in the humidity, maybe it will help me. And I'll put a little bit just on the top of my nose right here without going towards the bottom because it obviously doesn't want to be mattified right now. This is supposed to be the mattifying sister cousin formulation to their standard grip, Hydro Grip Primer, which is a great primer. I'm not a huge primer gal naturally, but it is one of those if I think I need an extra hand in staying power, I would absolutely give it a shot. But I don't wear it all the time because it is sticky, so every formulation doesn't want it. They also sent over a sponge, which I'm gonna save for the concealer and actually blend out with my camo sponge from e.l.f. right now. But their sponge is angled, round bottom, pretty standard feeling. This e.l.f. one is oddly soft. It allows me to move fast. Slightly concerned about the luminous matte situation, just because I know what they mean is like it's not cakey, but how matte? How matte? Like, I wish there was a scale for that. Because the one size concealer I recently tried is quite matte, but it's a hydrating matte. And I get that, you know, but a luminous matte confuses me because it's kind of like saying light dark. Oh my God, do you see that? It's a little bit of peeling on the primer, just a little bit. It might be mixing a bit with my brow glue there. So we'll give it a pass because, you know, my brow glue may be like giving a little residue right there. Hello, clogged pore. Anywho, this is where we are. It hasn't dried down that much. It's still pretty hydrating looking. Maybe if you don't blend it out, might be what we're working with. I really like that first shade, Nougat. That golden undertone looked really good. The next shade looked a little light to me. Coconut flakes for some reason. It doesn't look like the swatches yet on the arm. I don't know, but here we are. Because they look so light compared to that photo. I think I want a little lift here and a little lift here. I'm actually gonna go to the side of the nose too. So I haven't re-dipped yet. The doe foot has this little flip up, like when you curl your hair back in the day and flip it out like that. That's what it looks like on the corner. We're also gonna add this near the brow area, and I'll take a detailed brush to it. Am I risking it all right now? The chances of this drying on my face before I can blend it out? Possibly, but you're gonna have to do what you're gonna have to do on barbecue day. And I got my new pupper under the tape right now. I'm a multitasking gal at the moment. I had to go walk them for this. She's a little out of breath. It still looks quite hydrated, and I know I just look absolutely crazy, but let's start with the sponge. Pat this in. Okay, I have texture here naturally if you're new here. I'm a little scared to see how it goes, but I'm patting in place. That's looking really good. But how will it settle in the lines? I don't think it's gonna sit well with texture yet. That's my first impression, but who knows? They claim this is a lightweight formula with insane buildability for customized coverage. It doesn't mask the skin, always enhances your natural beauty. Vegan friendly, fragrance free, water sweat, and transfer proof. So this is the day. I will be sweating and I will be outside and I will want to see this performance. So we are ready for that. Blending wasn't too bad. It's not looking that bad in person. On camera, there's a little bit more of like, I don't know, sometimes I guess it looks a little dry underneath the brow right there. Hopefully not. We're gonna take the brush now and give it a go on the side that's really had time to settle, but also has the eye cream. So it's moving around pretty well. I really do hope I'm pleasantly surprised through this wear test. But see, my brow glue. I see where it's settling now. It's right on that little area. So I'm gonna scrape that away. It's hard to see it sometimes because it's transparent and it just depends on the formulation that goes on top of it. So that's where that is doing. It should be okay overall. You can see the brush really moves things around. Obviously better than the sponge that's gonna absorb and press in. But we're bright. This is as bright as I think I'd be willing to go. Let's see what our darkest shade, Graham Cracker, looks like. Over, I mean, this acne scar is usually like, we have one right here that annoys me. We have a little bit of discoloration right there that annoys me, but it might be so dark that it's our contour shade. So let's just pop this in right here first and see. Not dark enough to be dramatic, unless it's gonna set super dark on us, but that was kind of a safe bet to put it there. And it's actually helping a lot over these acne scars. Like, wow, coverage. It's giving skin tone. Weird, shocking. Cause I wouldn't have assumed that I look anything like the model for this shade. Quite happy about it though. Got a little bit of acne scars that I would like to perfect. Okay! Pleasantly surprised. Very happy. I'm feeling like this right now. I'm like, But these powders. So typically I've tried some of their lighter shades of their Easy Bake powder. I have tried more of a yellow tone banana bread, which for light, medium, and tan tones, like golden undertones. I think that shade looks like the lightest I would usually go. So the light one we have right now is Sugar Cookie, and it's for fair to tan skin tones, neutral undertones for ultra brightening. I don't want to do that right now. And then the next one up is Cupcake, which is fair to light, pink undertones, brighten and disguise under eye darkness. So from where we're sitting right now, I don't think I want that much brightness in that spot. I think we could put a tiny bit maybe on the inner corner, but I don't want to look like that during a daytime barbecue. You know what I mean? I feel like there's a chance we get a little ghostly. So I know a lot of people love the formulation. I just don't think those are the correct shades for me. Just looking right now, I don't see too much of a difference under eye wise, but we'll see longevity. The eye cream helped keep hydrated or maybe caused it not to stay as well throughout the day. We don't know yet. I will use Cupcake, which is the peachy pink one. What? I do think the packaging is gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. It's taking a little brush. Packing that onto the inner corner right here to kind of set it in those fine lines. And you can see the shine, but with the powder, the shine instantly goes away, as it should, as it should. Wow, my nose is really peeling. That's crazy. Something you just can't see until makeup really takes it there. And again, I did have like an acid-based facial. It wasn't peel particularly, but hydro peels are like very, very, very light peels, and I don't usually peel from them. But that was something new, at least to this degree. But I'm taking this across my eyelids because I do have very oily eyelids, and it is still quite glossy there, so I don't want to bring too much attention to that extra brow that we went over. I might put some bronzer over that in a second. For the rest of the face, I would like to hop over to this powder that I've been using a lot. This is the Jaclyn Cosmetics Sheer Medium. I think that will be nice around the rest of the face. She's a little tanner. I don't know if I've applied it with a brush like this, but we'll risk it together. I think that allows my face to be closer to like my body's shade compared to like ghostly, you know? So that's nice, and it gives our highlighted areas its own definition. So that's going across our forehead too, and it's very, very sheer, as they say, and the formulation's amazing. I reviewed it recently. This is just the correct tones for me. And it's rare to see like something that only has like six shades to be like, oh, that one actually really, really works for me, you know? I think it's six. Bring it down the neck. I'm also gonna use it for my nose. Can't really go much lower down the nose because we have our crisis, I guess. Bring it across the eyelid just in case I don't end up having time to do like a smoky liner. Bronzer or your, you know, tanner face powder or warmer situation always works. Just going across the crease with a nice blended motion. It just gives a little definition to the eyes. Makes it look like you tried a little bit more than you did. Naturally, I do wear the most makeup in the neighborhood, but I don't always wear makeup. That's the thing. They see me 99.9% of the time bare face, looking homeless, hair not done, you know? So then they get dressed up for the barbecues, and then I'm like, I guess I have to get dressed up too. I just took our Huda Beauty powder and put that kind of like across my eyelid towards lash line. I, again, might not have time, so quick little definition. Simple. If you know, you know. She's been living in my head rent free. A little blush first. It's not the brush for it, but we'll do it anyway. I'm kind of using it kind of to contour my cheeks a bit too. Just make sure it's nice and blended. And then a little highlight. All right, lips. Let's knock them out. I think today is a refi day, to be fully honest, because I want something long wear. So let's just do that. This is the Refi Taupe Lip Sculpt. You got a little dryness right there, but we'll be okay. Let's use the bottom clear sealant. The group chat is going crazy. That nose is really distracting. Okay, so that's our base level face right now. We'll see what I look like then today. Of course, I'm gonna give you starting point pictures and close-up cam footage, and I will see you guys after a couple hours. I do want to hit it with a little bit of this refresh spray from Hailey Beauty because this is probably gonna help this situation a lot. So I'm gonna do a little of that. Very fine. I gotta kind of prep it first, and it sprays kind of funny, to be honest. But even when I'm close by, it's like all over the face. But to be fully transparent, that's what I think I need. I might even put a little Fix Plus from MAC on it because I'm like, oh, it is what it is. I'm gonna take a clean side of my sponge, kind of press everything in, just press it. All right, I'll see you guys at the end of the day. As I would usually say, thy day. It makes no sense, I know. All right, We just got in from the barbecue. It is almost 9 o'clock. It's 8:58 at night. I have hot Cheeto stains on my fingers. That's the kind of day we're having. No touch-ups at all. 10-hour wear test, 8 of them being outside in the heat all freaking day. Let's look at it together. I did put on a lip oil instead for my lip because that's, oh my God. I have a lip oil on my teeth. I have barbecue on my teeth. It's that kind of day. Let's just look at the close-up cam footage and end-of-day photos, shall we? So, ignoring the disaster that my nose decided to be today, the under eyes are actually looking pretty good, and the acne scars we covered up look freaking flawless. The under eyes look a little less flawless. It does not like the big fine line that's underneath my eyes, which I like to call the great divide. It's quite substantial, and it is not happy in that spot. It's breaking up. It could be worse, but it could be better. That's what I really noticed in the beginning of the day. Also, the texture around my nose crevice where it meets my face. Not the favorite spot. Obviously, my nose is super oily right now, so not against this concealer, but it looks better there because the oils broke through and the concealer's being more forgiving on the texture. I didn't put a lot of the concealer on my nose itself because of my nose situation, so the oiliness is just due from everything else, all the heat. If anyone was looking for the results for this milk primer, my forehead looks freaking flawless. It's smooth as hell. It's not oily at all. And I get very oily around my brows, equal to my nose. So definitely worth another use. Wow, this feels amazing. Feels fresh, freshly applied. Does not feel sticky. Does not feel cakey. Looks extremely smooth. Very impressed as a skin concealer, and I'm really happy with how like it all worked out shade wise. That's pretty cool. I would use these shades again. I'm not sure I would have picked them initially because I am a little confused between the model and the actual shade on myself, but the under eyes don't look too unnatural, but they're still giving a really good highlighted effect, and they look really, really smooth. They look fresh minus that great divide, and that's saying a lot. So I've been comparing it in my head with the one size concealer the whole day, and it's very comparable. I think it's just that line is a little bit more noticeable than I think with this concealer. So I would give this an A minus. Yeah, I don't actually remember what I gave one size. I wanna say I probably gave it an A or A minus, but this one's gonna give A minus just because of fine line situation. So if you had like lines and you use it on your eyelids or like forehead and you have a lot of lines, that might become an issue. It might not look great unless you put something to smooth it out underneath it. It might not look great. I mean, that might not be what you want when you buy a concealer with this much coverage and this much long wearability. Like, that's typical. Not what I would associate with what your ideal performance would be. Otherwise, I'm pretty happy with everything. I would give the primer off first impressions an A. Yeah, we'll see it again soon. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you, Huda Beauty, for keeping me on your PR list and allowing me to get these before the release so I have time to make this video so you guys can see it when it releases online and in stores. So I appreciate you guys for watching today. If you would like to see any of my other videos, they will be on the screen right now, as well as the subscribe button, which you can hit if you have not yet and you would like to join our fam. Stick around for a bit and support my other content. I hope you guys are having a lovely, lovely end of May, and I'll see you guys in June. Thank you.